Ladies.
Hello.
Francesca, how are you, darling?
Welcome.
Peter, likewise. And what does it mean, GB? What the full name is?
Bonjour.
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 Fuck me. We'll see.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Likewise, good to see you. So, clearly, you ladies can handle pressure. You see it each and every day.
Yes.
7 days a week.
Yes.
Yep.
All of you are faced with a tough task tonight, cooking for 50 customers. Yes? And the objective of tonight, of course, is to make sure those 50 customers pay for their starter, their mains and dessert. Now, you all put yourselves forward as talented cooks.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
It's time to prove it.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready,
okay.
Ready.
Here we go. Okay, Francesca, what is the starter?
It's small calamari, shallow fried.
Yes.
With sweet chilli sauce.
That's right.
And then some bok choy at the bottom with some oyster sauce.
Exactly. So you score the inside to keep it flat.
Okay.
Okay.
So give them a little shake. Okay, so it's not too thick with corn flour. Okay, in and lay away from you. Yes?
Okay.
Lay away, again, lay them away.
Okay.
Bok choy in, okay. And you've got to do this really quickly. Touch of olive oil, and it wilts very quickly, like spinach.
Yep.
A few small flakes of chilli in there to roast off. A little bit of oyster sauce in. A few flakes of garlic, sliced very, very thinly. And then you just toss that over, okay? Quick toss, okay, and then out. Nice crispy squid. One, two, three, touch of sauce. Inside the chilli sauce, there's sugar, garlic, chilies. Okay, a little bit of soy sauce. Just visualise that in your head.
I'm trying.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Done. Don't look so worried. Relax. Yes?
I think I normally look worried, that's probably
more importantly, I'll tell you what to do. There's one person controlling this kitchen and four of you cooking.
Okay. Yep.
If we listen, do as you're told,
yep.
It's going to be a fucking great night.
Okay. No problem.
On your stations and good luck, yes?
Thank you.
Jean-Baptiste, let's go.
Got it.
Dans les premiers quatre tables, s'il vous plaît.
Oui.
How is everybody out there?
Very good, very, very, very busy.
Nice atmosphere?
Oui.
Good.
Yes? Okay, on order table five. Yeah, four covers table five. Four squid, four chicken, Ballantine, four crepe Suzette.
Right.
Yes, Gordon.
Yes, Gordon.
Yes, Gordon.
No. That was a really pathetic response. Yes? Yes, Gordon, yes, Chef. It'd be nice if we get a bit vocal, so it sort of gears you up ready for a really good service, yes? I'll start that again, okay?
Okay. All right.
On order, four covers table five. Four squid, four chicken, Ballantine, four crepe Suzette.
Yes, Gordon.
Thank you.
To each side.
No, no, no. Are you telling them what to do or should I tell them what to do?
You should tell them what
to do. Thank you. So shut the fuck up then.
Right, will do.
My name is Peter. I like to do anything that is a bit unusual, puts together unusual flavours.
My name's Lucy. I have been obsessed with food since I was about a year old, and being able to actually produce something and see enjoyment on people's faces, I think is just brilliant.
My name's GV. I like to cook everything really quickly. I don't have much by way of patience, so if it can be done fast, I'll do it fast.
My name's Francesca, and we've all had a lot of experience dealing with aggressive and irrational people, so I think that that will help us prepare for meeting Mr. Ramsay.
A&E is the busiest department in the whole hospital. Everyone running around, everything frantic. To me, it's the closest you get to running a professional kitchen.
I think we're all excellent cooks, and I think we're all desperately competitive.
I don't think we have anything to worry about being in the kitchen with Mr. Ramsay. I think he's the one that needs to watch out.
Right, GB.
Yes, Gordon.
How are you doing? You had the first ticket on four squid.
I'm doing good.
How long?
I'm doing good.
Yeah, give me a time, please.
At least 4 minutes, please.
4 minutes, thank you.
Yes.
Peter.
My presentation's crap.
No, listen to me. Listen. Peter, come here. Come here. There's no garlic in your bok choy. And there's no chilli.
There was. I put some chilli in.
Where is it then?
Little bits.
Where's the garlic then?
No,
I'm not here to argue.
I'll put some more in. Okay.
Peter, you're not here to argue. There's nothing in there. Start again.
It.
I'm going to be going to the fucking mental home in a minute. Any chance of going quicker? Otherwise, I'll get them to put a sign up. Average waiting time for Peter's table, 45 minutes. Join the queue. Okay? Can we get the plates cleaned? Yeah, that looks lovely. But the plates are fucking disgusting. So, get a little cloth out there and clean the plates.
Yeah?
Okay.
So
you must see all sorts of accidents, you know that?
We do. Huh? We do.
What's the worst ever sexual accident you've had in the middle of the night?
Now you're talking.
What do you mean, at work or at home?
No, not at work, no. Yeah, no, at work, yeah. Not at home, my God. I knew that'd get you going.
I can't possibly disclose that here.
What type of accident was it?
We've had some interesting vacuum cleaner injuries.
Serious?
Yeah.
What, they've got the nozzle stuck?
That sort of thing.
Oh, my God.
Vacuuming with their dressing gown open, you know.
Peter. The food's looking fantastic, but we can't afford to keep the customers waiting too long. Let's go, yes?
Yes, Gordon.
Otherwise, they won't be paying for anything, yes?
Yes, Gordon.
Let's go. Okay. Should we get it nice and tight, those plates?
I don't like squid, and I was really surprised. I've never had squid that wasn't rubbery and stuff before, and this was really, really good.
I loved it. I really like squid anyway, but the squid was cooked to perfection. I thought the texture was really, really good. Love the sweet chili sauce, the honey and that sauce, loved it. Perfect, really.
Okay, ladies, on order, yes? Four covers, table three. Three salad of squid, three chicken Ballantine, three crepe Suzette.
Yes, Gordon. Yes, Gordon.
Ladies, that's the last order. Okay, let's go. Gordon. GB.
Yes, Gordon.
Now, you've been the fastest tonight. Let's go. Last table for you. Four
okay,
squid
Gordon.
Away.
On it.
Three nice bits.
Just tracking these,
yeah? Look, yeah, one, two, okay. Three. There. And then drizzle your sauce around. Yeah? Watch. Just over the top, and that's it. Yeah, I can't make it any simpler than that. Good, please, go. Let's go. Well done, Peter. Finally, yes? OK, Jean-Baptiste. Right, yeah, slightly slow. The results?
Four in total are not happy to pay tonight.
Only four customers not paying for the starter?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. Yes?
That's good, very good.
That's fucking good news.
Is that good?
Well
yeah.
done.
Yeah,
no, 46 are paying, four aren't.
Huh?
Okay. It's not perfect, but it's bloody good.
Okay.
For the main course, I want everybody paying, yeah?
Yeah,
50
definitely.
Paying for that chicken leg, yeah?
Definitely.
Let's go.
Next on the menu, I'm off to France to help a British expat who's letting the side down.
It's a shrine to England, isn't it?
I mean, this place is festered with baked beans.
Yeah.
The brigade tackled the main course, a delicious bacon-wrapped chicken leg with a pea and broad bean risotto. And Trini and Susanna finally get a makeover.
Just don't put the brush inside his bum, OK?
Welcome back to the F Word. My pigs may not be long for this world, but they're still as competitive as their dad.
Come here. Hey, we're going to a show. Yes, you and I are going to a show.
I want to get fully involved in the pig world, so I've entered my girls into an agricultural show, the Royal Bath and West, which is like Crufts for pigs. In order to show them, I need to teach them to walk to heel. They say that pigs are as intelligent as dogs, so teaching them should be a piece of cake.
Oh, fucking hell. So I'm in a bit of an awkward situation now because I don't want to make myself look stupid at the show. And, you know, I don't go into it to come out third or fourth. You know, I want to win this fucking thing now.
So if I want to win, I've got to train hard.
I'm really fucking competitive. So we don't settle for bronze, we don't settle for silver, we're going for gold. Get in there. Come on, hey. Oh, fuck me. Come here. House, hey. There you go. Nice and snug. Good girl. Fucking hell. Getting better.
Later, Christine and Kevin, who we brought the pigs from, arrive with a surprise gift.
Thank you. The kids are going to love that. You know that.
It's for the pigs.
Are you having a laugh?
No, we're not having a laugh.
Now you want me to bath the fucking pigs in a swimming pool?
Yep.
Oh, shit. I'm going to get the kids.
So we got to work preparing a nice warm bath for the pigs.
Is that nice? In the pool! In the pool! Oh, quick!
There's
the
pool!
No, I nearly want to put the water there like that.
I mean, they just love the water and they love all the attention. I mean, you saw the one roll over and have a tummy tickle. She thinks it's brilliant.
Just don't put the brush inside his bum, okay?
Quick, lift up the tail. Right, ready? Nice big splash. Here we go. Yes! Oh, Meg! Sorry, Meg! Meg, I'm sorry. Meg!
Daddy, I thought they were going to be pigs.
Oh, no, don't roll over!
I mean, the difference is extraordinary in terms of how well presented they look, how smart they look, for what a fucking palaver.
With the pigs clean as a whistle, they're off to the show early to get settled in. But will Trini and Susanna win any prizes?
Right, ladies, step up a gear. Away now, yeah? Four covers table two. GB, hands. Four chicken away, please.
Yes, Gordon.
OK, away now. Four covers table five. Francesca, four chicken away, please.
Yes, Gordon.
Let's go. Thank you. Time for the main course. A bacon-wrapped chicken leg stuffed with pork and pistachio. Chicken legs. This is a thigh and the drumstick boned out.
And that brown meat is so full of flavour.
Stuffing, sausage meat, pistachio nuts.
And the pistachios give it a really nice sort of nutty flavour with a nice crunchy texture, slightly sweet.
Thyme, parsley, salt, pepper. Stuff.
Place that in the centre. Get your leg and fold it over.
Tin foil, season, olive oil, streaky bacon.
It gives it a lot of flavour, but more importantly, keeps it nice and moist. Place it in the centre and just roll it round. Squeeze the ends nice and tight.
Poach, 25 minutes. Chill, 30 minutes. Unwrap.
Look at it. Already, it looks sophisticated.
Hot pan, olive oil, season.
And the secret now is to get that bacon really nice and crispy. You just roll it round. Leave it to rest for a minute.
Sherry vinegar.
Deglaze the pan with some sherry vinegar. And it's really important that we deglaze inside that pan because that's what that flavour is. And it's not just the flavour of the chicken, it's the flavour of the bacon as well at the same time.
Masala wine.
It's a real sweet, dense, rich sauce that goes brilliantly with the pistachios.
Stock, reduce.
There we have a really nice 30-second sauce. And slice on an angle because you really want to show off those pistachios. That smells amazing. Absolutely delicious.
Stuffed chicken leg with masala sauce, done.
So, chicken leg is served with a very summery risotto done with broad beans and peas, yes?
And as you make a risotto, the most important thing is cleaning your pan down all the way around the outside. So all the rice is building up, okay?
Oh, it's
cooked evenly.
It's
right. Yeah, good.
And how do you tell when it's ready to add the next bit?
Good question.
Does it plump up?
Yeah, look, you can see the colour of it. Inside the risotto, there's a little hard core there. So the more translucent that becomes, the more cooked it is. See, there's like a little bit in there, a little white bit. As that disappears, it signifies that the rice is cooked.
Peas, a nice handful of broad beans. Yes? Right, butter in. Let's go.
Thanks.
Quick.
Yeah.
Right, parmesan cheese in there. Yeah?
Yep.
Get your spoon and start tasting, please. Now, when the parmesan cheese goes in, it dries it up.
Put butter and pepper on the other side just so you've got it available.
Yeah, it's nice.
Seasoning's okay?
Yep.
Right, I think we're ready for that one. So, give the plates a little shake. Now, we just slice them into two or three, yeah? So they stay nice and hot, yeah?
Yes.
If you put them to really thin slices and try to decorate it, it goes stone cold.
Okay.
Okay? And we want to keep that heat in there. Now, Francesca, are you happy with those?
Yes.
Yeah, would you pay for them?
Yes.
Yeah, good. Good, they look fantastic.
I'm happy to try
you. Well done. First plate out. Go, let's go, let's go.
Where are your boy?
Coming now.
There is some strange black debris in my pan.
What?
Look,
what?
Show me.
Oh, of course, but, no, but anyway.
What are you doing there? What is that?
I don't know.
Huh? Well, how do you manage that?
I don't know.
It sounds like a plastic container in there. Get them out. Yeah, did you start off with a clean pan?
I did.
You sure?
I thought I did. I may be wrong.
I don't think you did. You started cooking a dirty pan.
This
anyway, Peter,
pan.
Let's get it in the bin and start again, yes?
Throw them away.
Oh, just put the plates down. That's it. Oh, you're not even thinking now, Lou. I don't know why, but you're not helping clean the plates. It's almost like you're giving up, yeah?
I haven't given up.
Well, you should be putting dirty plates up there, then. That's all. Sorry, we're halfway through the fucking main course. Go table 14, please, yeah? Go. Hurry up. Yeah? Service, please. That's nice. Now, sauce
Gordon.
The rest of them. 2 seconds, JB. No, sauce the rest of them, I'll do that. Yes, JP, what's the matter?
One of the customers saying that the chicken is not cooked enough.
The chicken not cooked enough? The bacon or the chicken?
No, the chicken.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Is it raw?
It seems fine to me, to be honest.
It's been poached for 20 minutes. Sorry, JP, but they've already been pre-cooked, so we're getting them crispy. OK, where's it raw?
Chicken stock, please.
Oh, come on.
Sorry.
No, no.
Please.
Yeah, look, it's well cooked, look.
Yeah. There's nothing raw in there. Okay, mange. Come on, hurry up, eat it, fucking hell. Look, yeah, that's dry. That is not raw, sorry, yeah?
Okay.
Yes? Francesca, 3 chicken away, table 12, please, let's go.
Okay, can
I need
we
more
have
chicken,
oil?
Please.
One at a time, guys, yeah?
One let's chicken. Go.
Peter, I want you starting with a clean pan, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely spotless, yes? Right, Francesca, let's go. Come on, please.
Is off ready? Time. Oh, shit, sorry.
Fucking hell.
Here you are, guys, sorry.
Are you all right?
Yeah, you've got to take the pan to you.
Yeah.
Take the pan to you next time, yeah? That way we don't all get
chicken,
splashed.
Please.
Let's go, place out. Yeah, Lucy, you've got to be careful here when you work in a kitchen, yes?
Huh? I know.
Yeah, fucking how can I turn up a fucking accident and emergency tonight, yes? Right, ladies, can we all get on there, please? Yes?
Yes.
And finish this last table 3, I want excellent, okay? My ambition to get the nation cooking Sunday lunch has thrown up some real tough challenges. Some of them, I wouldn't even trust to boil a pan of water. I'm here in Grenoble in France and, surprise, surprise, it's taken me all bloody day to get here because the French are on strike. Bonjour, madame. Miserable bitch. They may have done better than us in the World Cup, but we can beat them in the kitchen. I'm here to help a Yorkshire couple who are letting the side down.
They think their food is the best in the world, their wine is the best, their cheese is the best, their meat is the best. I really need someone to teach me how to cook so I can wipe the smile off their faces.
Hello, how are you?
Hey, I'm
Vicky.
Fine.
Enchanté.
Enchanté.
Your neighbours, because obviously all French, the neighbours.
We've been round to his neighbours for dinner.
Yes.
However, we've not had the confidence to invite them back over. They've
really?
Come round for some drinks, but nothing cooked.
They're inviting us to their house for a meal,
yes.
And we're too ashamed to invite them back.
L'expérience que j'ai avec la nourriture anglaise, c'est du fast-food, du fish and chips et de la viande hein, et des patates. Potatoes.
And for me, it's not very elaborate and very often greasy and not very good.
What kind of food did you eat when you went round to their house?
Oh, they had wild boar pate that one of the women had actually gone and caught
Shot
the
it.
Wild boar,
wow.
Made the pate. It was out of this world. I don't know how to cook with the food they have here.
Right.
Because it's like vegetables,
yes.
Meat, fish, cheese,
uh-huh.
And you can't put it in a microwave and go ping. It's a shrine to England, isn't it?
This is not real, you know. This is.
And bear in mind, none of this stuff you can get here.
Baked beans and soup. What's in there?
Right. So in here we have more beans.
But I mean, this place is festered with baked beans.
Yeah, it is.
Get your coat.
Right.
We're going shopping. On a cherché pour quelques légumes ce matin, pour a Sunday lunch. 3 of them, yeah, nice.
Oh.
On the vine, lovely. Good. Now, that's not too scary, is it?
No, that's okay.
He's your best
mate
now,
yeah?
He's
nice, yeah.
Huh? Perfect.
C'est gentil, merci.
There you go. And do you know the nice thing about this? When they get to see you once a week, twice a week, they get to know the kids' names, they get to understand.
Yeah.
You become a bit of a local, then you get the stuff cheaper.
Yeah.
I'm going to get Vicky to cook a very simple dish using a cheap cut of lamb rump. They're going to bone it out, roll it, and then tie it.
On fait la viande.
Thank you.
Une excellente journée.
Vous aussi, là.
Merci, merci.
We're going to cook the lamb with couscous and an aubergine puree. It's the perfect Sunday lunch because you can make it for a lot of people and it's very easy to do. Score. The top like that for me.
Right, so why do we do that?
And so when it goes in the marinade, it starts to absorb the marinade. Look, what we do now is just get where the fat is into the marinade.
Into the marinade.
Okay. And that doesn't have to be done for sort of 3 or 4 days. It can honestly be done an hour before you need it.
That smells gorgeous.
So, aubergine.
I thought aubergines were really complicated and you had to salt them first or soak them.
Well, the reason why you have to salt them first is to get rid of that bitterness. Okay. And then mixing your hands through there, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Good. Onions,
uh-huh.
Straight into the pan.
Uh-huh.
Season it also with a nice cumin. So, have a look at the aubergine now.
Okay.
See? Don't worry about that
so
discolouring.
Yeah, it's changed colour slightly.
Yeah, all that water again, little squeeze out there, and look.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Yeah, that's the bitterness.
Yeah.
Okay, aubergines into the pan. Cook the aubergines with fresh tomato, mix them with onion and cumin, and then puree.
The lamb.
Okay.
Now, remember, no colour, no flavour. Okay, now, into the pan. Now, let me just show you something. I don't want to waste that.
That goes over the top.
Couscous is the perfect accompaniment to lamb. I'm using half a bouillon cube, which, don't worry, is acceptable even in France, but with fresh thyme for added flavour.
The stalk, OK, and just...
Add apple, sultanas, olive oil, and gently heat over bain-marie until it's fluffy.
So those are
halibut. Beautiful, yeah.
OK, it's not over.
Yeah. Et voilà!
Oh là 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 là! Qu'est-ce que nous avons la vitrine?
Cuisiner.
Ouais, on va goûter, on va goûter. C'est excellent. Hein?
You have changed my idea of English cooking. It's really good.
Très bon et la cuisine anglaise ressuscitée.
Parfait. Voilà. Thank you, chef.
Thank you.
Quatre. Voilà. There you go. Merci.
So our cooking is better than theirs, and we've got the Olympics. England 2, France 0.
I thought, yeah, the risotto was well balanced with the parmesan and really good al dente beans and peas that snap in your mouth. And the chicken was well cooked and the bacon was nice and smoking.
It's really fatty and the broad beans are not cooked properly. And also, in a restaurant, if you have risotto, it's usually like in a little, like, they've stuffed it into something to make it look like a little circle, I don't know, some kind of... And it was just like on the plate. There was too much of it.
Mine was perfect. I really, really enjoyed it. It was lovely.
Gordon? Yeah. OK, ladies, come over with the results, please. Leave the pancakes on the side. Ladies, let's go. Yeah, this is a crucial part for me, yes. I know we're slow, however, what was the result? How many customers out of 50 are paying for the main course?
32.
32 are paying?
Yeah. 18,
18 aren't paying. Why not? Why so many?
Main reason is the meat's a little bit fatty.
It's not a breast of chicken, it's a chicken leg, so it's a rustic cut.
Yeah, but that's what they said.
The pistachios, the pork stuffing.
No, they love that, they love that. But, you know, a bit of too much fat around the chicken.
Well, that's crazy, because every plate these girls sent out was fucking fantastic. I know we're slightly slow, but 18.
Yeah.
That's a disaster.
Nightmare.
OK. Yeah. Don't drop your heads on that one.
No,
yeah?
It's fine,
yeah?
We're going to come back.
Keep up there. I want all... the customers paying for the dessert, yeah? All 50 of them, yes?
Next on the menu, galloping gourmet Janet Street Porter goes fishing for low-fat food.
Ah! That's cuddles!
I give political Rottweiler John Humphreys a grilling in the recipe challenge.
When I hear you on the radio, just the pummeling you give those poor politicians, honestly, like lamb to slaughter, you're worse than a fucking vegetarian!
And the doctors tackle flambé with crepe Suzette.
Stand by with a fire blanket. Make sure you do not set fire to Dean's fucking chest. It's insured for a lot of money. Right, welcome back to the F Word. This week's recipe challenger is a real serious foodie. And he's even grumpier than Janet Street Porter.
You say that to all the girls. Right, I'm going to start chopping them.
OK, are you ready?
You do it. I'm ready.
Right, the rules are simple. The challenger has to come up with their best dish, and then I have to try and beat it with my version.
Have you been cheating, by the way, and looking at my recipe?
No. Have you? This recipe's been well-rehearsed, apparently. Is that right? It's been in the family for some years.
About 15 years. My son is a musician. He's a cellist.
Is he?
And his favourite food for hundreds and hundreds of years has been curry.
Curry?
Yeah.
That's amazing. Apparently your son is the same age as me, 39.
Oh, shut up.
No, but it's like having your dad in the kitchen.
I'm not prepared. Can we stop the recording? I'm going home now.
It's like having an old man in the kitchen. It's fantastic. Good to see you. And you look great for 63.
Well, I was 11 when I had him, yeah.
Okay? Oh, serious?
Yeah,
fantastic.
Yeah. I was 11 when I had him. I do have one who's only 5.
His name is?
And his name is Owen.
Owen, that's right.
And he's a joy. Should I confess at this stage, I'm not a natural chef, yeah?
You're highly competitive.
I am highly
competitive. You get up early in the morning.
Yes.
You don't like losing.
So that makes me a chef, right?
Yeah.
So
it
that
sounds like a great chef to me, trust me. You've got nothing to worry about. How are you going to sex that curry up?
I'm using the best end of lamb.
Ginger.
Lots and lots of red onions. The usual spices, obviously.
Yes. Garlic.
Garlic.
Ginger. Turmeric. Chili.
And chili. And
paprika.
Paprika.
So John's making a lamb curry, and it's from his son's recipe. Now, I'm doing a lamb curry as well. Very similar in spices with turmeric, cayenne, a little bit of chili, and then sweat it off with the onions, seal the meat, and then we're going to blend some almonds and poppy seeds.
No idea.
Now, because the curry is actually quite spicy, what I've done with the almonds is ground the almonds up with poppy seeds, and that makes it a lot more mellow. So, really nice and mild, and takes the heat out of the spices.
Why do you not want yours to be too hot, Gordon?
I'm not very good at things burning your palate from the minute we start. What do you think about John Prescott?
He adds to the humour of the nation, doesn't he, you know? Oh, I asked him about the Green Belt once. He said, Green Belt, one of Labour's great achievements. We're going to build on it. Well, you know, the man has a sense of humour. He is much maligned, is Mr. Prescott. Now, I'm going to mix my stuff up in here.
Right. That's amazing when you listen to your show in the mornings how on the ball you are. Now you're just cooking, chopping a few onions, making your son's curry, and you're all over the shop, John.
I'm absolutely pathetic.
Shall I get a seat out for you and we'll sit down and turn the lights out? There's going to be a lot of politicians getting sweet revenge on watching this now, you know that. John, how are we doing?
Well, this is the crucial stage. This is where the real creativity comes in, Gordon.
I'm dying to taste yours, you know that?
This is the...
It smells amazing.
Really? I just realised I scratched my eye. I had a call the other day.
Yes.
Some months ago, from my son. He'd been cooking a curry.
Oh, no.
Went to bed and all the rest of it.
Rubbed
woke up at 3 o'clock in the morning in agony. Absolutely in agony. Thought he was going blind. But he got a tiny, tiny bit of chilli in his eye. And they said he could have gone blind if he hadn't.
Thank God he didn't go for a pee. No, just imagine. And it's happened before in chefs, you know, when they're busy, flat out, middle of service, chili, chop, 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 chop. Chef, can I go for a pee? And they come back and they're, like, doubled up. I mean, like, really doubled up. Dangerous stuff, especially when it's a really hot chili.
Do you know something, Gordon?
Go on.
I didn't want to know that.
Sorry. Nice.
Oh, I made a complete pig's ear of this.
It doesn't look that bad. Come on.
Total pig's ear. Huh? It doesn't look that bad. Oh, thank you.
No, it doesn't.
What are you
going
to do?
Oh, you put the spices in there?
No.
No? Spices in there?
Spices had better go in, haven't they? You've been deliberately distracting me, haven't you? Is this the technique that you use, Gordon?
John, I honestly thought you were going to be a lot more together than this, you know that? Being such a well-organised man.
I've let you down.
When I hear you on the radio, just the pummeling you give those poor politicians, honestly, it's like lamb to slaughter, you're worse than a fucking vegetarian. Can I have a little taste?
Yeah.
That's nice.
Is it?
That's lovely. That is very, very nice. It does taste like an authentic curry. I'm not starting to worry or panic, but I have to say, it's nice. And the tomatoes...
Panicking just a little bit?
Just a little
just
bit now.
Just a teeny-weeny bit?
But it looks like a curry, you know. It does look good. Right, that's ready now. Just needs to be brought up to the bowl and left to simmer for 10 minutes, both curries. Happy, John?
Delirious.
Delirious.
And may I say...
Yes.
...confident.
Mm-hmm. Cyber Doctor. Ladies, how are we?
Gordon.
How are you, big boy? Nice well?
Yeah.
Good to see you. How did you enjoy your chicken?
That was lovely.
Yes?
Nice. What I liked about it was that it was like Ramsay. It was what it says on the tin. It is what it is. I like the dark meat, so it was nice.
I think a lot of times the chicken leg tastes 10 times better than the breast.
Definitely.
What was the food like on Shangas? Lots of liquid lunches.
It was fish and chips every Friday.
Serious.
Good salad every day.
Yeah.
We were encouraged not to eat carbohydrates because your energy levels dip in the afternoon.
Yeah.
So the food was good.
What's the most difficult scene you've ever done?
Probably being I was naked full frontal in front of 6 crew, all men.
Serious.
I insisted. And it was the coldest day in July.
Oh.
Freezing cold.
So did you really
I've got other strong assets.
Yeah, I know you have.
Everyone knows what my weak spots are.
Is it his hairy chest?
No.
Oh, that's a strong point. That's
nice. Hairy back. Oh, fuck
God. God, he's got hairy back. God, I've got hairy feet. I should have been a hobbit.
Is that Forest of Dean natural or have you had an implant?
Forest of Dean, no, is it's natural. The worrying thing is it's still growing.
So,
it's still growing. You know, I've got it insured. No, seriously, it's insured. Daisy Duke insured her legs in Dukes of Hazzard. I thought, oh, that made me think.
Would you pay for your dinner so far?
Definitely. Let him pay, yes.
See you later, yes. I didn't think it was possible, but foodie gobshite Janet Street Porter has found something with a bigger mouth than her.
The British are certainly getting more adventurous when it comes to exotic meats.
I'm off to Britain's first crocodile farm.
which sounds somewhat extraordinary as they're not exactly indigenous to Cambridgeshire. Now, crocodile's a very low-fat meat, and it has got a pretty nice taste. So I can see that a farmer might think, oh, well, it's a new way to make money, but I'd be worried that it might be kind of cruel. But if it's not cruel, if they're happy, if I can be assured that they're happy crocs, then I don't really have a problem with it. Looking at this countryside, it doesn't exactly remind you of the Everglades, does it? Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Andy. Britain's first croc farmer. Are these particularly vicious crocodiles you're leading me towards?
Only one of them.
That's Kitty's over there. She's the most aggressive of all of them.
That one?
Yeah.
Well, isn't this a bit cruel to keep these crocodiles in this confined space?
The enclosure is about four times as big as it actually needs to be. They've got 4,000-gallon tank there. They can swim around. They can jump out the water.
So what about escaping? I mean, have the villagers got a bit anxious and put extra barbed wire in the gardens?
No, because these are cold-blooded animals. They can't survive in our climate. If they got outside, they'd slow right down and stop, and we'd just pick them up again.
So what would you normally feed them?
Usually I feed them on chicken. We're feeding them the pigs today, stillborn pigs.
I wish you hadn't said that.
It's important to remember that these would have been incinerated.
Why have you got the pig on a rod, if you don't mind me asking?
That's how you can fish a crocodile. We're going to get you to dangle him in and see if you can catch a croc.
So you don't just, like, chuck them in?
Yeah. If you take that and hang over this side.
Andy, this does seem a very dangerous way of feeding.
Here she comes. There's Cuddles.
That's Cuddles? Cuddles? It's your Auntie Janet. So what bits of the crocodile do you eat?
If I catch a little one, that's going to be the easiest way to actually show you. This one's smaller.
Not very happy.
He gets spare ribs, which obviously is a rib cage.
Yeah.
As on anything. The legs, they call crocodile wings.
Yeah.
And then the prime meat is actually on the tail here, which is a solid muscle. It's cutting steaks like swordfish or anything else.
Andy.
Right, there we go, Smiler.
It'll be a few years before Smiler and chums are ready to eat, so I'm going to an exotic meat supplier in Battersea, who are the cream when it comes to croc. Hello. Is this in case you forget what all the meat is? Because
exactly.
By the time it's in the packet, it all looks more or less the same. Do you really sell gnu?
Yeah, wildebeest is a better name.
Now, what about crocodile?
Yeah, I've got some. Yeah, I've got some in here.
Is it a novelty or is it something that there's really a growing demand for?
It was a novelty. Now we are selling between 500 and 600 kilos a month.
That's a lot of crocodile.
It's a bloody lot of crocodile. We'd love to get more. People are now ordering it, reordering it, because they like the product, not because it's a gimmick. Would you like to try some?
I'd love to. Oh, great.
There's some crocodile.
Fabulous. Any chance of taking a bit of kangaroo?
Yeah, absolutely.
About
go
it?
For it. Pick that one.
That's great. I have no idea how to cook this croc, so it's time to ask Massimo, head chef at Cinnamon K in South London, where crocodile is always on the menu. Is it popular?
He's very popular. He's been in the menu for 3 years now. So
for 3 years, these enough, people in this area of South London, they're all vibed up about crocodile. Why is it so popular?
Well, he's a nice new piece of meat and he's nice and healthy.
Low fat.
There's no fat at all and it's quite good.
OK, well, why don't you show me how you cook
it? Yes, please.
So I'd like to have a go.
OK, so what we're doing today is the crocodile skewers with three fry noodles. The crocodile is going to be marinated in ginger and lime.
What's my first task?
Skewers.
Doing skewers like that?
Yes.
Down the middle. So I've got to marinate it.
Squeeze some lime.
Okay, it's dead simple.
Yeah, very simple.
I want the three best looking bits.
Yes.
Wow! Well, let's go and taste it, Massimo. I'm starving.
Eat a crocodile, then put some noodles in your mouth.
Tastes really interesting.
For me, it's like between monkfish and chicken. Looks
it is
like
a
monkfish.
Delicate flavour.
Yeah, it is.
It's got more flavour than chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Hi there.
Hello.
Hello. Right, I've got a mystery food for you here. What do you think here?
A cross between chicken and tuna.
So it's a meaty texture, so it could be a meaty fish.
It's fish.
It's fish, yeah. Right? What kind of fish?
Like giant squid or something.
Like giant squid. That is such a stupid answer. Gordon!
It's me. Tell me what you think of that.
Right.
Croc.
It's fresh.
It's fresh. It's...
Did you catch it yourself?
No. What do you reckon?
A bit chewy.
It's a bit chewy. Maybe it wasn't marinated long enough.
And it's like a dry swordfish. Yeah, the texture's quite weird, isn't it?
Funnily enough, when I asked people what it was, some thought it was chicken and some thought it was tuna, because there's that crossover with really, really meaty fish.
Yeah. Is it going to take on? I mean, that doesn't do much for me, you know that.
Do you serve anything like that in your restaurant?
You're having a fucking laugh, aren't you? What, a salad of a crocodile?
Would you ever serve crocodile?
I'd never serve it. I mean, you know, that's tasteless. I think that you were a fucking crocodile in your previous life, you know that, before you got here.
No, I wasn't a crocodile. Yep. Listen, in your restaurants, do you serve any exotic meats at all?
Maybe on the fucking Great Barrier Reef, I can understand, but in the middle of London, I would not serve fucking crocodile on my plate. Fucking, is there a shutter here we can pull down, for fuck's sake? Janet, I've got to go on with dessert, yes? Right, ladies. Come round, please, quickly. This is Martin. Yes, Martin's from the La Gondola restaurant in Derby. And he has to be the number one crepe Suzette man in the country today. He's going to show you exactly what to do very quickly. Watch carefully what he does, because you're then going into the restaurant, OK, and doing it at the side of the table. Learn from the master.
Sugar. Some butter.
So what you're making now is a caramel.
Caramelizing the sugar. Zesting, yes?
Ladies, this is not the fucking generation game yet. You've all got to get it right, yes? This one counts. Big time, yes?
Yeah, big time. Big time.
Yeah, GB, Peter, and Francesca. I want all 50 customers paying for their pancakes, yes?
All right.
So you take it a little bit further to get a little light golden brown, yes?
Yes, it's got to go caramelised, yes.
Almost like a treacle colour.
Exactly, yes.
Yeah?
Now we put the orange juice in.
Oh, nice.
Orange segments in.
I'm trying to keep the orange segments whole, yeah? We don't want them all broken up into little bits.
Right, now all we do now is we add the pancakes.
So here we go, look, in there like that. Okay, over. That over there like that.
Right,
now watch, heat the... in.
I'm gonna have to press that on the pancake.
These are very dangerous. Get the flame.
There we go, look.
Yeah, and then
you just tip it over.
Just tilt it.
Ooh. Yeah.
And then...
It's just like doing Christmas.
Look, there you go. Burn off the alcohol, see?
Yep.
It's a flambé. It's the whole idea of a crepe Suzette. Yeah, yeah? Look.
So, I'm not saying that.
No flames, no flambé. So, organise your trolleys, get the oranges into a smaller bowl, get your pancakes on there, yes? Make sure there's no paper between your pancakes. Yeah. Yes? Let's go.
Right.
Martin, Peter, let's go.
OK, where are our trolleys?
This is the exciting thing about Crepe Suzette, it's theatre. Now, these customers love it, yes, madam?
Yes, it has been fun.
Good, there we go. OK, a little bit more colour.
Yeah. And then we're going to wait for that colour to go and then add the orange juice, that's what I mean.
Right,
looking for that kind of brown
alcohol
colour.
Alcohol last, that's right, yeah. You'll be fine, absolutely fine, yes? You shocked me, you know that. You played rugby, you saved lives, and now you're worried about making a simple pancake. Let's go.
I will never complain in a restaurant again, I have to say. If my food is late, I just... That's fine.
The good news is we can all treat you if there's an accident.
Just need to heat the grand marnier. Come on, cook, cook, cook. Yay! Hurrah! It is on fire.
Then pan on again, another table, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah. Stand by with a fire blanket. Make sure you do not set fire to Dean's fucking chest. It's insured for a lot of money. Or to his feet, yes. And good, right, got it in. Good. And good, nice. Lovely, right, burn off the alcohol.
Yeah.
Don't you put that thing down before you fucking burn me. Good. Come on, Dean, give him a round of applause. My God almighty.
Yeah,
good. Now. Thank you.
Next on the menu, will Trini and Susanna make me proud in the World Cup for pigs?
Yes. We're waiting for you now. The pigs are in the ring, so we need to get a move on.
And the doctors find out what the diners thought of their bedside manner.
How many of the customers are paying for the dessert? Welcome back to the F Word. Now, before we find out how the desserts went down, time to make a grumpy old man start crying.
Oh, you're a confident git. Look, doesn't it look beautiful? Just tell me that looks beautiful.
It does look nice. I just like this little moment. This is my moment now.
Go on, then. What?
How can anyone judge against my dish?
OK, the moment of truth.
So dish number one, this is dish number two.
OK.
Up you go.
Oh, it smells great.
It's so hot.
Mm. Yeah, it's got a kick, but it's not got taste.
No spices apart from chilli.
Should we try the other one? This looks better.
It looks creamy. Okay. It's still quite lumpy.
That's much better.
I think there are too many almonds just floating around in it.
The meat and the other dish was a lot better.
I think the sauce is a bit bland.
John, I'm not a curry expert, you know that. We don't have it on the menu anywhere.
I understand.
Although chefs love curry. Normally about 12 o'clock at night on Friday night.
Yeah. OK, I have the results.
OK, well, who won?
He's annoying, isn't he?
He is annoying. Yes. He's French.
Well done.
Yes! Get in there! Well done.
It was a great pleasure.
I knew I was going to win.
Now, yeah, I know you knew.
Do me a big favour.
What?
Fuck off out my kitchen, please. Thank you. John, take care.
See you, Gordon.
It's the moment of truth. The World Cup final for pigs. The Bath and West Show.
The Royal Bath and West Show is the biggest agricultural event in the country, attracting 160,000 visitors. Animals of all shapes and sizes have been judged, with only the finest livestock receiving awards. By entering my Berkshires, I want to raise awareness about these English rare breeds.
Ah, Jack, look at them, aren't they beautiful?
I'm also determined to win.
If he thinks he can come down here with those wretched Berkshires and beat us experienced pig breeders, he's got another thing coming.
With the competition this fierce, I'm glad Tana's agreed to walk one of the pigs herself.
Yeah. Very right, nice.
Yeah. Yeah, you're in there as well. Oh dear, there you go. You look like a evil matron. Yes. Do you want to go see the little pigs?
Yeah.
Come on, my girls. Don't let me down now. Come on, ladies.
And for moral support, Mum's turned up with the whole family.
Hey, I didn't know everybody was coming.
But there's worse around the corner. King of Pigs, Hugh Furley Whittingstall, will be watching. No pressure then.
Slightly shitting myself.
Are you? It's a nerve-wracking moment. Have you done a lot of training?
No.
I have done a lot of training, yes. Anything you can give us as a last-minute bit of advice?
Well, you know the sticking board, but the board is just like a blinker. Use it like blinkers to stop them being distracted and just to turn them.
Yeah.
Yes. We're waiting for you now. The pigs are in the ring, so we need to get a move on.
Okay. Finally, it's showtime. Six rosettes will be awarded for the best quality pigs, but any misbehaviour will be frowned upon.
Here we go. Here we go. Stand still, you little fucker.
Come on.
Oh! Hey.
He's not watching the pig enough. He's watching around more than he's watching the pig, so occasionally she's getting away from him. Whereas Tana is doing what she was advised to do, which was to concentrate on her own pig and not worry about anybody else's.
He's taking Tana's pig very seriously.
Yeah.
He's giving it a proper look. That means he's thinking of giving it a try.
Controlling the pig means the judge gets a proper look and can give points for criteria such as shape, mobility and teat alignment.
Good girl.
A pile of rosettes on the desk. They'll start dishing them out in a minute.
All right.
A moment of truth.
The votes are counted. All we can do now is hope. The steward is about to announce the winner. My trotters are crossed.
Me!
Well done, Alice.
Well done, Alice.
No! The rosettes are slipping away. Second place goes to a teenager.
Third?
No.
Fourth, no.
Fifth? No.
Oh, shit.
Oh, come on. There's only one place left.
It's got to be Gordon.
Yeah! Thank you very much. Thank you.
Despite Tana keeping Trini under better control, it turns out Susanna is a much higher quality pig. But Tana gets a special award for her pig handling skills.
Special prize?
Yes. Much better.
Specially controlled.
I thought she'd do even better. I thought she'd be placed nearer the top.
I thought she would come first or second.
Yeah.
I can't believe you beat me. I think mine was much better than yours. I really enjoyed it, and I'm quite shocked that I did enjoy it.
I mean, Tana amazed me. I was amazed at the way she managed to control her pig and just how, I suppose, calm she was with it. Because it's fucking hard in there.
Winning course, really, wasn't it? You can't fault that. Made at your table, alcohol didn't overwhelm the orange juice, it was just beautiful.
Really nice and fruity, lovely flavours. Not too sweet, not too bitter, just right.
Okay, Jean-Baptiste, please.
Wait, got him.
Okay, yeah, slightly manic out there, frantic, but theatre-wise, it looked fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the colour looked brilliant.
Yeah.
How many of the customers are paying for the dessert?
Everyone.
Everyone.
Yeah!
That's fantastic.
Yes, one course.
Everybody.
Yes.
That's the first time ever.
Yes. Oh my God.
Everyone's actually paid for dessert. Well done. So, four customers refused to pay for their starter. 18 didn't pay for the main. Okay. But everyone agreed to pay for the pudding. That's fucking good news. So, out of 150 plates you served, 128 of them were paid for. Well done. Yes. It's not perfect, but it's fucking brilliant. I'm telling you now. So far, you've been the best performing brigade. And, yes, I'm really happy you liked it, because there's a strong possibility you may be coming back.
Oh, okay. God.
And it's my fucking kitchen, OK? Yes,
chef.
Yes, chef.
Roger that, chef.